This is the final 10th part of Amazon EKS tutorial. In this lesson, I'll show you how to integrate AWS Secrets Manager with EKS. Secrets Manager is used to securely store credentials such as passwords, API tokens, usernames, and similar data. First of all, we'll create a username and a password in AWS Secrets Manager like this. By default, if you want to use this set of key-value pairs and mount them to the pod, you'll get a single JSON object, which is not what most applications would expect. In this video, I'll show you how to parse each value and mount them as environment variables, such as my password and my username, to the pod inside Kubernetes. Additionally, I'll show you how to mount the same secrets as files so that your application can read those files during startup. First of all, we need to install generic store CSI driver that would integrate secrets with many different cloud providers. This CSI driver, which stands for Container Storage Interface, meaning those secrets will be mounted as Kubernetes volumes. But don't worry, I'll show you how to use those secrets as environment variables as well inside the container. That's why we need to explicitly enable it in the Helm chart. This will create additional RBAC policies needed to use environment variables. Next, we need to install a cloud-specific provider. In this case, of course, we need AWS. You can use GCP, Azure, and some other providers also available. Since EKS pod identities are still new and not supported by all Kubernetes extensions, let's use old OpenID Connect provider, and first we need to create a trust policy. This trust policy is used not by the CSI driver itself, but rather the application that needs access to a specific secret. So in this case, we'll create a trust policy for the sample application that we'll deploy later. It will be deployed in the 12 example namespace, and the Kubernetes service account will be my app. And the next step is to create IAM role for that specific application. Let's call it my app secrets and use EKS name as a prefix. Next, we need to grant access for this application to a specific secret in AWS. Just to simplify this tutorial, I'll use a wildcard, which you should never use in production. You should only grant access to a specific AWS secret using its IREN. Then we need to attach this policy to the application IAM role. Finally, we need the role IREN to link AWS IAM with Kubernetes service account. You can automate this by using Kubernetes provider or by passing the IREN as a Helm argument. I showed an example in the previous section. Alright, let's go ahead and apply Terraform. The next step is to create a secret in AWS Secrets Manager. Click on Store a new secret. Select Other type of secret. For the first key, let's use username, and for the value, you can provide arbitrary string. For the second key, let's use password. Keep those secrets exactly the same because we're going to parse them next. Let's call this secret my app secret with 3 because I already created a couple of them for testing. Then click store. That's going to be our secret name, but for the permissions, you need to use IREN of that secret. For this example, it's important to follow the same naming since we authorized the Kubernetes account only in this namespace. Next, we need to create secret provider class. You need to place it in the same namespace and region. Then, for the object, use the secret name. If you want to parse and mount values instead of JSON object with the secret, you need to use James path and select the keys that we specified in AWS Secrets Manager. To mount the secrets as environment variables, you also need to create a secrets object and reference those keys from the previous section. I intentionally use different names and aliases to be clear about which key to reference. Next is a very important part, linking this Kubernetes service account with IAM role using this annotation. You can get this IRN from the Terraform output or copy it from the AWS console. Finally, for the deployment itself, you must use the service account with annotation. Now, you can mount your secrets as regular files inside the container, like this. Files named username and password with corresponding values. You can also mount those secrets as environment variables. It's up to you, whatever is easier. I personally prefer environment variables. At the bottom of the deployment, you need to create a volume from the secret class that we created earlier. For the first time, to catch any errors, try to follow the driver log. If you have permission errors, you'll see them here or inside other AWS provider that we also deployed. Now, let's go ahead and deploy our application. Let's get the pods. To verify if you have secrets, let's SSH to the pod using the following command. First, let's try to print the value from the username file, and the value is my actual username. Then, let's try the password file, and we have DevOps 123. For the environment variables, you can use env command to get all of them inside the container. So, we have my password variable as well as my username. In the next lesson, I'll try to cover topics that you send me during the release of this playlist. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.